FoxTrot64 here again, back with my first ever video tutorial for anything ever. I'm kind of excited. Okay, so, a friend of mine and an acquaintance wanted me to explain to them how to do their own Let's Play. And that's kind of complicated, and I'm sure there's plenty of other people out there who want a tutorial like this, a kind of all-in-one sort of thing, or at least as close to that as you can possibly get. I'm pretty much gonna warn you right now, there is no single one tutorial that's going to explain everything that you'll want to know. So, this is just going to tell you my setup and how I do it. This might not work for your computer, you might not like it as much as plenty of other options that are out there. Get out of my messages. Okay, so, first video is just going to be a whole bunch of stuff that you're probably gonna want or need. Like I said, be aware, there's plenty of other options out there. There's other programs that can do the same stuff as most of these ones. But definitely, you will want a program that does the same thing as WinRAR. There's also 7-Zip, and I'm sure there's another one. So, here we have WinRAR 4.2. I'm not sure if this is a trial or not. And you're going to want to know whether your computer is a 32-bit or a 64-bit. Well, you can check this is go to Control Panel, go down to System, and it will tell you System Type. Mine's a 64-bit. Now, if you have a 64-bit, a 32-bit will still work, but the vice versa of that is not true. So I'm just going to get the 64-bit one here. And what you want to do is get out of that, run it. It was moved or deleted, okay. I think my security system is just not letting me. Okay. Hang on a second, let me figure this out. Okay, here we have the actual WinRAR site. I probably should have gone here first. Okay, so you just choose whatever language, and I'm guessing it's gonna be English that you want. Oh, I have to buy it? Or okay. Now, this seems like it's just going to be a trial, but I'm pretty sure that that trial never ends. I've seen plenty of people say that, and I'm pretty sure that the one that I have is actually a quote-unquote trial version. Yeah, run it anyway, I don't care. Yeah, run it. Do it. Okay, so you'll just choose wherever you want to put it. You can read all that if you want to, but I wouldn't advise it. Just install. Yeah, just associate all these files with it. I don't know what JAR is. You can add it to your desktop or start menu or create a program group. I'm not gonna do that. Sure. Whatever. Click OK. And done. Yeah, I got a 32-bit one, but I think I might still have the setup for my 64-bit version that I already had. So, that's WinRAR. What else do we need? We need, well, I did make one list for both emulator and console Let's Plays. So, depending on whether you're wanting to play, like, a console game, like on the Wii or the PlayStation or whatever, or if you're wanting to play it on an emulator, which is best for recording handheld game systems, then you might not need this. But what I'm getting right here, if I can move the thing up, is an emulator for the Game Boy Advance. It's called Visual Boy Advance. You may or may not have heard of it. Probably the best Game Boy Advance emulator that there is. Yeah, just get the latest version, Windows, download. Come on now. Okay, do I want to open it or save it? I'm going to save it. I'm going to put it in desktop tutorial files. And yeah, just save it there. open up the folder, and it's a zipped file. Now, what you need to open a zipped file, which is basically a compressed file for sending things over the internet, is WinRAR. So you would go to extract files, extract here, or extract to. I usually like to do extract to because that creates a new folder for it instead of all the files just being, you know, out. And here you have the application. And I will explain everything how this works later on. Right now I'm only telling you what you need, not exactly how to use it yet. All right, what else we got? Ah, no cache GBA. That one's a doozy. That one is a DS and a Game Boy Advance emulator. However, for Game Boy Advance games, I would still say go with the Virtual Boy. What? Okay. I, copied that link just not very long ago, but whatever. Guess I'll just go to the site. Go to the download page. Download latest version. And here we have it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was the link that I copied. Now if it will just load. Okay. Save, save as. And save. Oh, come on, is this gonna take... This probably gonna take a little while. Okay, well, I'm just gonna cut back to when I have it downloaded and see you then, because you don't want to sit here and watch this. Hang on. Okay, it's finished. Open folder. And it's another zip file, what do you know? Extract to. Yeah, it doesn't take very long usually to do these things. And here we have no cache GBA. The first thing it does when you start it is ask for what game you want to play on it, and I'm not going to demonstrate that right now because I have another program that goes with that that is entirely optional, but I would highly recommend it. NoCache GBA uses a really, really tiny screen, and there's no way that you can make it bigger unless you use NoCache Zoomer. And the tiny screen really bothers me. It's bad for recording, so for our purposes, you probably want NoCache Zoomer. You know, record videos with a bigger screen and in higher, resolution. So here, we're going to Emu Paradise. One of the best sites for these kinds of things. Now, why did not go? Come on now. Ugh, whatever. Just gonna type it in. Fucking internet. Of course the internet chooses now, of all times, to start derping on me. Of all the times it could have chosen, now it just had to be, you know. Okay, I'm gonna make another cut again. Hang on. Okay, I got it to load. Okay. Emu Paradise. Pretty great site for emulators and everything emulator related, including the actual games for them. But we'll get to that in a minute. For right now, download NoCache Zoomer. Save, save as. I know you can't see it, it's down below the... Okay. And save. Open folder. Extract to. And the way NoCache Zoomer works, when you open it up, the very first thing it's going to ask for is the NoCache GBA file that you got before. Do not, and I mean do not open up anything else with it except for the NoCache GBA application. Otherwise, very bad things will happen to you, I can promise. Nothing too serious, but it's just annoying as heck. It will, go into a loop, somewhat. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's just don't. Okay, now as for the actual ROMs themselves, which is the games that you'd be playing, there are plenty of places to get those at, but like I said, usually I go with Emu Paradise on this, just because it's a pretty great site for this stuff, I promise you. It has all kinds of ROMs and ISOs and games for all kinds of systems. And by systems, I mean, emulators. So we're gonna go with Virtual Boy. No, wait, not Virtual Boy, I meant Visual Boy. Sorry about that. So it would say Nintendo Game Boy somewhere. I guess that would be under handheld, wouldn't it? Yeah. And here we have an ad. How exciting. Hopefully it won't do that again. Okay. So you can just go ahead and pick any game. I'm gonna go with a Pokemon game. How about Red Rescue Team? Why not? And of course it will also have the ROMs in like different versions and languages, but it doesn't really matter so much to me as long as I get it in the right language. There are probably going to be like several download links. How do I click on them? I guess I just... Yeah. Just regular download, I guess, whatever. So basically what you would do is download it and save it onto your computer. It's probably also going to be a zipped file that you would have to extract. I'm not actually going to download it because that's just unnecessary. Instead, later on, I will show you what to do once you have a ROM and how to use it. I will not be demonstrating how to use hacks. That's just unnecessary. There are all kinds of other tutorials for that. If you want to know that, you can look it up. I'm not going to explain that, because that's a whole other thing. Okay, this is also unnecessary and kind of frustrating. But for some games, I'm sure you're not going to want to use a keyboard. You're going to want to use, like, a controller of some kind. If you have an Xbox controller, then you should have no problem. Plug it in, it works just fine. However, if you're a PS3 person, not person, what the f- like I am. Different story. You have to get a driver and it's just all kinds of not fun, but I'm gonna walk you through it. I really need to set my internet browser to not do that every time. You would go to this site, and I'm gonna put all these links in the description, by the way, so yeah. They do have a tutorial video for how to use this application that lets you use the PS3 controller, but I'm gonna explain it anyway. 32-bit and 64-bit all in one. Save as, it's another zip file. See how useful that WinRAR's coming in handy? Yeah. And it has to download. Come on now! I love how that last 1% takes longer than the rest of the entire thing. Open the folder. Extract 2. Here we have Motion Enjoy. And you would just pick a place to install it, create a program shortcut if you want, and then you would click install if you want to install it. However, I already have it installed and I don't want to have to redo everything. Yes, I know. So, after you install it and you click on it, I actually have mine over here in the corner. It will look something like this. If I'm not mistaken, this requires an internet connection, but there is a version out there that doesn't, or so I have heard. I'm not entirely sure if it works. I gave it to my friend Holly, and I don't remember if she's tried it yet or not. But if you're interested in that, then you can look that up. But if you're viewing this video right now, then odds are you have internet connection, so it shouldn't be a problem. I will explain how to use this later. Right now, let's go back. X-Patter. Another something that you're going to need in order to use the controller. And I'm just going to go... Okay, pick a language and pick a country. Next. Hi, John. I don't care. Next. And there is a demo video if you're interested in that. In case this doesn't help. Oh, damn it, it's not free. That's really weird because I got mine for free. Let me see here. Maybe with this. Oh, is that an ad or is that? No, that's the actual thing. Okay. No, that's an ad. Is it? No. I guess it's this. Open or save? Save! Save as. X-Patter 5.3, sure. And I better copy down this link and replace that one. Yeah. Okay, open folder. Extract 2 again. And here we have X-Patter. Oh, damn it. Okay, well I can't help you so much with getting X-Patter, but I'm sure there's a tutorial out there that can. Once you do eventually get it, and you bring it up, it should look, if it'll come up, like this, assuming that you don't have your controller plugged in, which I don't right now, but I will explain how to use it later on anyway. I'm really sorry about that, but there doesn't seem to be much I can do. I got mine a long time ago. I guess it's different now. You have to pay for it now or something. I don't know what happened with that. And that's completely optional anyway. I'm not even sure if you need X-Patter if you have DS3 tool, but I think I did. So, you can just look into that. Personally, I would just save myself the time and get an Xbox controller if I wasn't so stubborn. But I didn't want to pay, like, how much an Xbox controller? Like, a PS3 controller is 50 bucks, depending. Anyway. Now for actual recording software, Cam Studio. Cam Studio is actually what I'm using to record this video right now. It's a free desktop screen recorder, and the latest version of it is always going to be right here on camstudio.org. You don't need the lossless video codec. I tried it, and I didn't even really like it. It didn't work for me so well. So, just go to SourceForge, download it. 2, 1. And I guess this one is an actual, like, installer instead of a zip file, so you would run it. And whenever it decides to run. Yes, I'm sure I want to run the program. Yes! Okay, next. Accept. Nobody ever reads these things. Pick a place to install it. Sure, why not? You can create a shortcut if you want to. Create a desktop icon if you want to. And then you would hit install, but I already have mine installed, and so I'm not going to do that. Yes, I know. Now, once you have it installed, the program looks like this. Or, like, all this is going to be black. Or it might just not be expanded at all. It might just be, like, a little tiny without all this. I don't really know how to show you that. Yeah, it might look like this. I'm not sure what it comes looking like. But, yeah, that's that. So, what else? Virtual dub, yes. Ooh, very important for Let's Plays. Any kind of Let's Plays, really. You want virtual dub, trust me. You kind of almost need it, sort of. Internet Explorer. Need to get a different browser. You know, I tried Google Chrome, and it actually ran slower than Internet Explorer 9 did on my computer for some reason. I don't know. Anyway, virtual dub, yeah. You want. Whichever bit release will work on your computer. I just went for a 64-bit release. And you would save as, save it there. Let it download for a few seconds. Thank God I have at least halfway decent internet. AT&T kinda sucks, but it's not completely terrible. Okay, extract two. And I don't know which one of these is the actual, like, that's not it. That's it. Okay. It's the one that says VDub64, I guess. With actual VEE, not just the letter V. Should look like this. Something like this. And just close out of it for now. I will show you how to use that along with everything else later on. Couple of video codecs that I would personally recommend. What a codec is it's basically kind of this little thing that injects itself into CamStudio and VirtualDub for video compression. That is to make your files smaller while still having a set amount of quality. I'm not exactly sure how it all works, but I know that you definitely want video codecs. You don't want your video to be completely uncompressed, because even though that way the quality will be flawless, you will end up with a giant file, and I mean giant. Even with one of these codecs, after I record a 20-minute video of Darksiders 2, the file is about 5.5 gigabytes. So you can imagine without, I believe a 20-minute video would probably be like 10 gigabytes, maybe, something like that. And that's just a guesstimate. So, just run it. Yes. Next step. Quick installation. You don't need any of this crap that they're trying to give you. Decline? This is gonna take a little bit, so I'm just gonna do another cut. Because you don't need to see this. Okay. You would hit install now. I'm not going to do that. Actually, I don't really remember how this one works, so I'm gonna. Is it gonna install it? Yes. No, maybe. It's doing something. Okay. Now this will give you the DivX Plus software program. It's basically for like video conversion and such things like that. And just media playback in general. I don't really use it. All I really want is the codec, because it's a really good codec if your computer has the power to run it. It takes a pretty powerful processor, and you might not be able to use it for that reason. But if you can, oh my god, it's worth it. So, What you would do here is run the setup, install the program, do whatever else, and it should just kind of inject that codec into these other programs. Now, with the PIC video codec, I really don't like it, but I can't find a better one to do what I need it to do, unfortunately. No, I don't want to go to Amazon. Screw you. Okay, now if you scroll down here, and I mean way the heck down here, download direct link. What you would do is run it. Now it says trialware right there, and that might be true, it might just be a trial. I actually got mine from elsewhere. I found a tutorial video on YouTube that had it. I think what I did was I searched for best virtual dub settings, and somebody had a video that with a link to this codec in it. So if you want to go look around for that, then you can. I'm not actually entirely sure about this. I mean, like I said, there's not one single tutorial that's gonna tell you everything, so I'm just telling you what I can. I couldn't actually go back and find all the stuff that I have now where I got it from, because everything that I have now is the result of looking through probably at least like 50 different tutorials on YouTube, which you could do, but I'm trying to save you at least most of that time by doing this. Of course, I'm gonna have to do, like, two videos after this, but, yeah. What? What is this? Okay, I don't remember it doing that when I got mine. Is it done? Oh, I guess not. Next. Yeah, sure, why not? Next. No, I actually do not. But I do want it at least as the secondary. I guess you would hit yes if that thing came up. It probably won't come up for you unless you already have an older one. This is newer than the one that I already have. I don't need that. So now, let me just test something. Oh, I guess not. Okay, well, never mind then. Okay. Now I'm actually going to go and show you the hardware that you're... Well, actually, no, hang on a second. For editing videos and putting them together, you're also going to need some kind of video editing software. If you have Windows, then Windows Movie Maker is free. I think now there's Windows Live Movie Maker, which is newer, but my god, does it suck. You definitely want to try, if you can, to get Windows Movie Maker 2. At the very least, which still sucks, but what are you gonna do? You could get Pinnacle Studio. I actually went and got myself Sony Vegas Pro 11, probably one of the best video editing programs that there is out there. Look for it, and if you can afford it, by all means, do. It's worth it, or at least for the most part. Depends on where you're getting it from. On Amazon, I saw an older one go for like $1,000. That's not worth it. It should only be, like, no more than maybe 500. It's kind of one of those programs like Photoshop where it's like, "Fuh, that's expensive, but look at all this crap it can do." So, okay. Now that I've explained that, I'm not gonna show you how to use the video editing software because there's, like, millions of different ones. And if I show you mine, then it's gonna be somewhat worthless. I don't know about worthless, but what's the word I'm looking for? Like, it won't be any help, really. It'll be pointless, that's the word I'm looking for. Okay, so now I'm gonna go and show you the hardware that you're going to need. Okay, now there I have my PlayStation 3. It's kind of an old one. And connected to it, I have an HDMI. That's not the HDMI, that's the HDMI. And that is connected to my TV, in case I ever want to play the game, like, on my actual TV. When I record, I don't use my TV, but sometimes I like to switch back, and there's where it is in my TV. Most interesting thing in the world. And there is my TV. It's a very big-ass TV. And there's some drawings on the wall, very distracting. Okay, and I also have composite cables connected to mine, which includes S-Video. Now, you definitely want to use S-Video. Oh, and there's my Dazzle, which is my capture device. You need a capture device of some kind. And there's plenty of kinds out there, but I use Dazzle, just because it works. You definitely want to use the S-Video cable instead of the yellow one, because it's much higher quality. And probably, well, debatably, the biggest determinant of what your video quality is going to be is what kind of capture card you use, and just what kind of output you're using in the first place. I can't record in HDMI, unfortunately, because that just wouldn't work. And I have the Dazzle connected to my computer. So, that's how that connection works. It's connected via USB, right there, in the side of my Alienware computer that glows. It's awesome. And here for my microphone, this is the one that I usually use. I'm just gonna go and set it over here on the bed. And it got stuck on my chair. That is my floor. Okay, there. It's a headset microphone. I got it for like, it was like 60 bucks, I think. My grandparents actually got it for me for Christmas. And it works pretty well. It's actually the one that I'm using right now to record this commentary. I'm not recording the commentary with my camera. And for co-commentary Let's Plays, that doesn't work very well because you have to speak like directly into it. So for those, I use a much bigger microphone. I believe it's called the Blue Yeti. It might just be the Yeti. It's a USB microphone. You can usually find them for like 140 to 200 bucks on like Amazon and eBay and things like that. It's USB and it's got all these kinds of like settings and crap and buttons and things, and that thing lights up when it's recording and it's really cool. And it's a very good microphone. So I would recommend it.